Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back for another TOS video. So today we got the weekly battle to take down, which is Earth Shikigami stage is back. So, yep, with this I thought of featuring a new team, and then last week's 100% dark bonus has been nice to me. I got Morris, the card that I wanted, and then of course with the addition of Princess Woodbury, which is considered Toy Pixie as well. I finally made a PR Diablo team. So, time to feature a new Diablo playstyle. Alright, so here I am with my new Diablo team. We can see that Isabel, Butterfly, Margaret, the Queen Bee is not here anymore. It's a totally revamped team. Yep. So you can see that what the only old card left is actually Magnus, and then the rest is Toy Pixies. Yep, so I would say that this team's overhealing capability is super high. It's massive. I would say it's really really massive, and I'm just stunned by the damage PR Diablo can give out in terms of overheal damage. Alright, so first round there, I tried to store as much CD as possible, mainly because damn, sync up again. Every time. Go away, thank you. Okay. Alright, mainly the Clara, the Nutcracker, CD is extremely high. I'm planning to feed Harpies to it soon once he up one more skill level. Alright, so round 3. Is it round 3? We have a so-called mini boss with a over defense of 200k. Right, so as you can see, two set of three hard runes managed to bypass 200k defense. So I think that is very, very, very strong. Alright, so after that is more storing already. As you can see, once I do not dissolve hard runes, it means that I'm storing, because typically once you dissolve hard runes, the amount of overheal is too massive. You pretty much just sweep every single mini mob there. Alright, so 8 turn, Diablo is up. So I'm kind of happy that I max CD my Diablo. It's going to be very useful in future. I have my max Princess Woodbury as well. So what's left is actually Magnus, Nutcracker or Clara, and Morris the Teddy Bear, in which I can max out this week because Queen of Heart ultimate stage is back, in which her active skill is the same as Morris. So yup, happy feeling then. Okay, next mini boss stage is actually this stage is extremely dangerous. So as you can see, I'm quite low on heart runes, so I just did a heart convert there, and then as you can see, Baphomet, auto Baphomet and Medusa is at CE1. So yup, of course take down the two Baphomet if not you're dead. Okay, so Medusa there actually have initial shield, so and then she's at a CD of 2, which is very fortunate. As you can see, my bot now is actually very low, in fact no hard runes at all. Alright, so with this quickly heal up. If not, I'm dead. So of course 3 hard runes is more than enough to heal back to full HP, because my HP is so low and elf recovery is so high. Okay, so with this, I can slack off a bit since Medusa is at a CD of 2. Other than that, this stage shouldn't be a problem. Once you take down Baphomet, this stage shouldn't be a problem at all. Alright, moving on. So typically, I hate the Shikigami stage. It's so extremely long with a battle of 12. So the entire video takes like forever, man. And I don't know if you can hear the construction at the back of the video because it's so noisy here. Hopefully the sound doesn't get through the mic. If not, it's gonna be very very noisy. Alright, so more mini mob stages. Nothing much to take note of, pretty much. It's just a gnome. If you're running a Diablo team, take note of the gnome, because double attack is gonna kill a Diablo team. Alright, so Belten, this is Mufasa here. Phantom skill, which ignores your tumbler, and then four turns for you to take Mufasa down. So in my opinion, I think with that amount of overheal back there, I think it is quite possible to take Mufasa down. Just that the amount of hard rune drop rate now is like crap. Like crap. So here I'm just trying my best to do as much damage as possible. You can see that my overheal here isn't exactly very very strong. So which, oh, it's battle 9, not battle 10, sorry. Okay, so this is where I tried I'm thinking what kind of active turn on, because I want to feature a big burst at the boss as possible. So yep, one Morris convert, I can see that amount of hard rune plus one more set of hard rune as a sky drop together with Dragonic Compulsion. My first effect of Dragonic Compulsion is to actually increase recovery by 50%. So 50% on top of my original recovery. You can see that 170k recovery. Boom. That's what? 1.4 million overheal. That's way too sick, man. Alright, so for this stage, sure enough, I have Enchant Shield mob. So you know that overheal does not go through Enchant Shield, even if you dissolve hard runes. Alright, so this stage is gonna take forever. I'm just gonna quickly skip through this stage, because in fact I can't die here. It's just that it's gonna take forever. I don't think you want to see me slapping this witch for like 2 minutes plus, so I'm just gonna skip right past this part. Alright. Alright, so we're done. So battle 11. So 11 is just another simple crescendo mob. We have Damwon here. So CD3 with crescendo. So crescendo, as an old player, you pretty much know, lower the HP, the high attack, and when it reached below 30%, he will start to attack twice. So of course, you hitting twice will mean death for Diablo team. So you want to control your damage to leave it just above 30%, and then after that he will just do a counter attack, he'll attack you, and then you'll give him back the damage, and then pretty much he'll just kill himself. Alright, so you can see there, low HP high attack, so you can see he actually hit himself 220k damage. So after that he's back at CD2, then pretty much this is your chance to kill him off. If not, you're pretty much dead. Alright, so off he goes. Simple crescendo mob thing down there. Alright, so we come to the boss here with this Earth Shikigami. First HP bar. Your runes will be must, and then it will only reveal to you once you start moving your runestones. Alright, so which is not really a threat, I would say, compared to skills nowadays with mask trails or completely masking your runes after you defeat the enemy. So this is pretty much very very forgiving really. And CD1, yep. So if in one turn you run out of hard runes, and then you are dead. So in fact now I can actually turn on Princess Woodbury. I didn't know that Diablo's active and Princess Woodbury doesn't stack at all. So I could have just turned it on here. Right, so I waited too long. But anyway, I didn't die, so it's fine. Alright, so you can see that I ran out of hard runes again. So that's where I turn on Morris together with Woodbury. So with this, pretty much I can just one hit kill the Shikigami. Yeah, no, I didn't. 2 little hard runes. Okay, one last spin. Alright, off he goes. The second HP bar is actually this. you'll bring your HP all the way to 1, and then your shield will be on CD1. So of course this is where I come and I'll perform my big burst here. The big bang. Okay, so as you can see that my Diablo, I actually wanted to activate Diablo's Link skill, but then I couldn't turn it on because Woodbury's active is still there. So with Clara the Nutcrackers active and Saruman's active, you can see that even without Diablo's Link skill, 6.7 million overheal damage. Super OP! And then you can see that at the start of the video, my Diablo team isn't maxed out at all. Isn't all max a team that is all max? You can see that Magnus is not max level, Clara is not max level, Maurice is not max level. So there's really plenty of improvement, rooms for improvement for this team. And then I cannot imagine its total damage, overheal damage when it's at all max. Alright, so this will be it. Earth Shikigami extra video. Hopefully you guys enjoy my first PR Diablo's playstyle. And then with this, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye bye. Hey guys, thanks a lot for checking out my videos. If you like my gameplay, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more upcoming videos. Peace out.